I'm worried for VG Gaming that they don't get there, though. I think they need to play
yeah,
really
but
well.
But at the same time, they have. Look at their base defense with Shrapnel, Split Shot, Shell Demon, and Barrier. They have the necessary tools to get there.
Is this going to be a game similar to the Cloud9 game where they, like, if I Team Secret wants to push, they're going to find themselves against a very strong wall?
Yes.
They're going to overcome
the Great Wall of China.
If they get a 20k gold lead, they're not going to
The Great Wall of China, dude.
The Great Wall of China. I like how that sounds.
Wow.
Yeah.
Stone Gaze is amazing here. I think that's. They wouldn't pick up Medusa just for her late game carry potential and for base defense if it wasn't for the new Stone Gaze. It's not really new anymore, but Team Secret has an in-your-face lineup, and Medusa has had a really good score against that this tournament, so that's very nice.
Ben, question to you. Wow. Important. Do you think Jagannaut, when he's spinning, shouldn't get Stone Gaze? Because since he's spinning, he's not actually looking at Medusa all the time.
That would be nice.
That's interesting.
Good theory.
Fair enough. Anyways, we're going to go into the game right now. It's going to be the third game versus Secret versus VG Gaming. Whoever wins this is going to go to the finals of the winner bracket or the upper bracket, however you want to call it. We have two amazing casters, the TA3 final casters. Once again together, LDL Luminance, this is all yours. Good luck.
Well, Lumi, you said better than TA3 finals. One of the best games you cast for game one. Can this game 3 deliver? No, stakes not quite as high, but it's a big one. Secret on the Radiant, Vici the Dire. Both teams looking to contest this Radiant jungle early. A smoke.
Ooh, love
off
one
the
smoke.
Back.
Yeah, they actually bought two smoke. One on FY, one on Fenrir. I'm not sure what exactly you're looking to find here. They know that the level 1 rune, especially in the bottom, will be contested.
Are they trying to bait with these heroes from the river? And
it could go
for a backstab
so badly here. Kuro is going to break
gonna get
the smoke.
Revealed. Well,
and that's it.
Smoke's over, folks. And that's really big, actually, because smokes are your most precious resource when you're running a duo like Shadow Demon Mirana.
Yeah. It's also...
They're still going in here, but I don't think they even
Well,
tried
they get the
Red
rune,
kill.
I guess, so it pays for the smoke, in
well,
a sense.
But Secret get the top rune for free, so I don't really know. That's obviously, I'd say, a win for Secret there. Also, Vici's still not warding the woods. They do have a couple of observers and sentries. They'll plant
they saw
one
that
sentry
one
down,
placed.
But that was pinged out. They might even deward this
Actually,
before the creep spawn.
Huh.
They saw both. Oh, man. This
I like
bad
how
for
both
Vici.
Those wards could counter the one that saw them, but. I don't think Mirana ever saw that ward because she never had the high ground vision. In any case, I'm surprised that the Shadow Demon didn't pick up boots first. Because generally when you play this kind of combo, the SD is your initiator, but...
Alright, Lumi, we might have some action here bottom. Is Ice going to take an impale?
Oh,
he's
wow.
dropping low to the quills already. Not going to be an easy lane for your Batrider offlane, even with the boots first. Meanwhile, Super pressing up on the mid. FY may be setting up for an arrow here. They want to go on Arteezy early. The arrow's... just barely going to miss. That was damn close. That would have been first blood.
But
look how low Arteezy already is.
The thing about this kind of Mirana play, you could just sit there and keep missing arrows.
Denied.
But the fact that you're throwing them, like... As a mid player that's facing arrows all day, it is just so annoying to play against. You're going to miss a couple of CS as a result. But
that
thankfully...
Is for sure. Meanwhile, bottom lane, Ice almost finished off, and he's very low on regen.
He already used a salve, too.
Yeah,
so.
he may have to ferry out some additional regen here. The bottle, I believe, coming out for super now. No, just some tangos for the time being. Yeah, he does go for the Wraith Band first, so won't have the bottle gold for some time. But even if Ice wants to ferry regen, he's going to have to wait a while for this.
Yeah. Maybe he starts making some kind of creep skip play. You just lead the next creep wave into the neutral camp and whatnot. Also, I'm surprised by the fact that Kuro didn't get Hex at level 1, because...
Courier mid, FY trying to snipe it, but a bit too late to get in range for that.
The Hex level 1 gives you much more longer stun duration compared to Impale, but obviously Impale does damage, so trade-offs.
So, looking at the way the lanes are developing, Vici Gaming, they draft the Shadow Demon Mirana. Oh, they're going to impale Ice bottom. Could be the first blood. He's going to firefight with a double damager. Can he actually turn this one against Puppy? Uh-oh. This could be bad. He's low. Not dead yet. The Hex comes out. They try to finish off Ice. He feeds the first blood. Oh, no. Had the Observer Ward. Had the Vision, too. New Kuro was in the neighborhood, but just unable to get the kill in time.
Oh, that one's just barely out of the range of the D ward.
Well, a small piece of salvation here for Vici.
Meanwhile, looks like an arrow has landed on the mid lane. Arteezy not going to die. Just take a little bit of harass. But it feels like this FY Mirana has not really done a lot of work. It's
not showing. It's not slowing down the Shadow Fiend. He's 16-3. You're running a sniper mid who on paper can somewhat counter and control the Shadow Fiend, especially early on, but they haven't killed Arteezy. They haven't slowed down his farm. Puppy's jungle has not really been contested. You look at last game, he was level 3 at like 8 minutes as Chen. This game, level 3 at 3 minutes. It's right. An Enchantress, to be fair. It doesn't offer quite as much in the mid game, but they're just not getting enough done. And now Fenrir, top lane, gonna actually get caught up by Blade Fury, but Sai doesn't want to chase that. I'm a little bit worried about overextending.
Yeah, I'm just not sure what this Mirana is supposed to do if you don't get these ganks off. I was, when they picked up the Shadow Demon, arrow is gonna land. Wow, that's a long range arrow. Can they actually do enough damage to get the kill though?
They
He's gonna have
it.
Spin. Looks like the right click is gonna get delivered by Shadow.
Meanwhile, mid lane, Arteezy being pursued. Secondary shrapnel coming out.
Can
he
get
not
the
quite
third
enough.
One?
Another third shrapnel. He gets the kill. Big plays by Super. He'll get stomped and counter initiated on, but I don't know if the Chen creeps alone get the job done. Well, what they couldn't do with an arrow, they do solo. The level 3 shrapnel at level 5. Super going with the more standard build nowadays for Sniper, and that little bit of extra damage making the difference.
It's a super strong build. It's so hard to just run away. From Sniper one,
especially for a squishy hero like Shadow Fiend. Four armor, 670 health, very immobile. That is so big for Secret. Still though, for Vici, but still, you look at Secret, they have four heroes farm you well. All things considered, Shadow Fiend is a good comeback hero, and they still lead this laning stage pretty substantially.
Yeah. I mean, wait, why is this... Oh, Arteezy denies his partner Centaur just to get a soul.
Give me that soul, puppy. Well, it's probably going to despawn fairly soon. Meanwhile, S4 diving this bottom tower quite aggressively, but he'll start to take heavy tower damage. He's only got a single
tower?
Stick charge. Help me, please. He's going to die to the tower. A rare overextension by S4 was trying to harass Ice with quills and run him down, but
I wonder
that's
if
a
it's...
very uncharacteristic misplay.
Yeah, I wonder if the big stage is getting to these people, because last game, Super solo got solo killed by Arteezy. Same thing here. And then now we have a random dive by S4.
He gets baited in by Ice, but Ice was very healthy. He's also could just hug this cliff line, and there's no way you're going to hit him with the quills.
Yeah, he was fire-flying through trees. I mean, is that even... Really
I think he thought the tower aggro would work differently and just wasn't able to juggle it off in
arrow
time. These mistakes happen on the big stage.
All right.
Suddenly, Medusa and Sniper, your two lead farmers. Arteezy's still farming well. Of course, running the Enchantress, they probably won't have a ton of stacks for him like he's accustomed to. And in fact, they don't have any right now.
Yeah.
So. Any kills they get in Arteezy mean a lot more than those games where he's got a freely and fully stocked jungle for him to go back to. They're going to look to go in on Arteezy now. The shrapnel coming out. They have Assassinate on Super. Might be able to get a solo kill. Arteezy has to be ever so careful here.
Yeah, well, he's got a bottle regen.
That's
so
true.
He could bottle through the assassinate.
Yeah, if he gets caught in shrapnel, though, he's going to... I think it's enough damage to break the bottle charges. Yeah, 48, so he does have to be cautious.
Yeah, one thing I'm very concerned about is Puppy, because, like the panel pointed out, you don't pick Enchantress to farm in the jungle, and so far, I think
he's getting chased mid. They're going in hot. FY's here. The arrow's going to connect. They don't even need the assassinate. A big takedown here in the middle lane as the Shadow Fiend for Arteezy will die.
Yeah, right now Puppy needs to do a lot, and you gotta start by getting this tier 1 tower, but kind of Batrider is probably one of the most perfect heroes to slow down the push at least. The creep wave's gone.
Yeah, and Ice recovering nicely. He gives up the first blood, but he's now level 5 in the offlane, and that one kill, it didn't really accomplish much for him, but he's just done a good job of playing patiently. He was given a bit of a freebie by his 4. I also like Fenrir's rotations. He comes bottom so that even if they get the initial Impale Hex on the Batrider, they can't really go on him.
S4 has a haste rune, but they see him, though.
Oh, no.
So capture.
Arrow
going to
connect.
Land.
S4 just walks him in. He's going to die as well. Oh, this dire ward. You go back to that D ward attempt, Luffy, where they were just inches short of the D ward.
They saw that one being placed.
Oh,
they
man.
Pinged it out on minute 1.
Secret. Perhaps the pressure of the big stage getting to them. As veteran of a lineup as they are, you really wouldn't expect it, but... Oh, it's just the little things. Dota truly is a game of inches.
Yeah. The most important member of Vici Gaming to me is actually the Medusa. Because if you look at this Vici Gaming lineup, if they fall behind, the lineup's completely papered in. They need some frontline. And a fat Medusa is the person they want, right? If somebody with Mana Shield or Stone Gaze, it is so hard to fight and kill her or run past her.
Secret have no answers for Medusa later. They have good physical damage, but all their heroes need to stand and face the Medusa.
Apart from just killing her outright.
Actually, they have Mana Drain, so they have like a pseudo answer, but you don't really have great Necro Bolt carries. Arrow mid, looking for Arteezy. He'll dodge that.
Barely missing it.
But the pressure is constant, and his net worth is now 800 down, even though he leads the CS charts. It's only two deaths, but you see just a kill or two here or there really makes the difference. And of course, some of these CS are the jungle creeps, which give you significantly less gold per creep.
Yeah. I mean, I want to say that FY is being the better Enchantress than Puppy is right now. Like, he's doing what Enchantress should be doing, right? Just harassing nonstop. If you don't force the kill, great. You slow down his farm.
The problem for Puppy is there's two supports always off the map, right? There's a Shadow Demon and a Mirana constantly missing. So if he tries to make, say, a play on mid, those two could just be raiding there and turn around. S4 gonna get disrupted here bottom lane. They have a lasso available. They get it off too. S4, will this be another death for him? They line up for the arrow. It won't connect, though.
He's
so fast. Lets him get out. If that arrow hits, he dies again, and he's going to go back in. Can he turn this one?
I don't know.
It's risky. If he dies there again, man, that's 0-3 safely in Bristle. That's a real pain, a real problem for Secret, but is able to barely survive.
So this is where Secret really have, I want to say, a big weakness. At least against VG Gaming. Out of the four games they have played, VG Gaming has won the early phase every single game.
Here comes the smoke from Secret, by the way, in the Radiant jungle, swinging around.
Now, granted, in the other three game, it's not every single lane that loses. So when Secret loses one lane, they somehow recover. And for example, if Zai loses lane, he gets farmed a little bit later on. But when you lose all of the lane, who's going to be your spike in the mid game? Like, who's going to turn things around, give you an early tower, give you a little bit of bump? Is it going to be Puppy on his
gank? They're technically losing the lanes, but it's not by a huge margin. As they smoke, they look to go in on black, but he's going to reveal it.
He's got Becky off.
Now they have time to react. He's really not the hero they want to engage on. Meanwhile, bottom, disruption coming out onto your Bristle back. He'll get caught by the arrow follow-up. Can they bring him down? The Quill stack up. He will fall, and then back the other way where they're chasing down Kuro. Ice has no mana here right now. No lasso for a few seconds. Can Arteezy turn it? The Chen creeps coming, or rather the Enchantress creeps coming in. Omni slash on the black. Not really doing a whole lot.
They're spinning on him right now. He is somewhat slowed down.
Man, four heroes walking around, not getting anything done.
Batrider's trapped on the high ground. Doesn't have mana for the TP. They drop the ward. They see him. A nice
this game, just unfortunate mistake after mistake for both teams.
Yeah. Ice now dying a second time, although as a Batrider, you could give away one of those two. Meanwhile, Kuro, though, might actually slide to a solo assassinate. That shrapnel was so huge.
Seven stick charges, not enough. Mega kill solo mid sniper against an Enchantress. Really?
Every pup stream.
This is fun super time for him. Uh-oh. Arteezy might turn.
One race. Two race. Blind race up. Oh!
What a play. That ends a mega kill streak. Right
That's huge.
A massive swing of gold.
I just have flashback.
800 gold swing plus.
That was beautiful.
Arteezy was like 1k plus down on the sniper before that.
Yeah.
My goodness, what a turn.
But again, I think Dusa is just, I mean, the net worth doesn't show, but if you don't count the sniper having a mega kill streak and then Arteezy getting the streak bonus, she's actually like the lead farmer, and she's farming extremely well. It's going to be a point booster first, just for extra health.
So looking at VG Gaming, they've had a nice laning stage, but you walk into the mid game, they have heroes that don't really excel in larger scale engagements. Shadow Demon Mirana, more of your single target pickoff types, as Ice will be pursued a bit bottom. They need the Batrider blink, and they need Ice to make plays. It's going to be a fairly slow blink, but he is closing in on it.
Yeah,
considering the way the game started, still a decent timing. But to me, he is the key for VG Gaming to keep this game at least on even footing until the Dusa and the Sniper can get fat.
You're absolutely right. I think VG Gaming is very single-dimensional on that aspect. They could only go for ganks. They can't really teamfight. Although, Arrow, it's going to scout things out.
Arteezy actually got revealed here, so the Roche attempt is over. Well, maybe not. Maybe Secret still go for it. They're going to try to roll up the bottom lane.
Get a T1.
VG Gaming don't have the Bat Blink. Even if they did, it would be tough to defend this tower.
Yeah.
I think they just have to sack it. Secret might... Do they even go for two? Despite the laning stage not going well, they are the stronger five-man lineup at this stage. When Medusa gets big, that changes, but... It's kind of a weak window right now for VG.
I'm very surprised that Black has been freezing the lane up on the top, because he noticed the Roshan play, right? And then, which transitioned to a tier 1 push. I think he should have been just pushing the tower hard, turning his Ring of Aquila on, for example. But looks like he's just more content in terms of slow farming.
I want to point out, Super just used the Shrapnel. He scouted the Ancient stack here. Something VG Gaming could contest with the Shadow Demon Mirana gank, potentially with the Batrider. That shrapnel.
Hard to steal it though.
It's hard to steal the stack, but maybe they can ambush Secret going for it.
S4, how dead is he?
Oh, he's pretty dead.
Yeah.
But what's dead too? Oh, Kuroki, I love that attempt there. The sniper comes so close to dying.
I think most players wouldn't even think about, like, oh.
He's got full health with Mask of Madness. Yeah, I'm going to finger him. He was so close. That branch, dude. I think that branch just hit the difference and saved him.
Yeah.
It was damn close.
Now he'll think twice about turning on his Mask of Madness in these fights.
It's a big kill. You know, it's kind of funny the way that they almost turn on the sniper, but delaying the Bristleback mech, S4 would easily have it now if it weren't for the four deaths. Disruption, Soulcatcher, but is able to Blade Fury dodge this. He has the Omni Slash. Fenrir going to end up going down. Moonlight Shadow.
Oh.
He turns. He gets auto attack down. Now Sniper laying into them from the high ground. Assassinate coming out, but the Healing Ward will keep him alive. Not long enough, though.
Soulcatcher
getting stomped. They bring in Black. Everybody rotating mid as the Kuroki Lion brought low.
Oh,
another arrow again on the mark. S4 might end up going down. They're going to Stone Gaze. Keeping Puppy back, focusing down the Bristleback. It's death number 5 for S4. His mech still delayed. He only has 150 gold towards the recipe. This might be the worst game that S4 has had on Secret ever.
Yeah, I think so. S4 generally is a very consistent player. Always really does well. That Windrunner game from game one, we saw how many big shackles. But, you know, when S4 doesn't do well, when Arteezy's having a very tough time on the mid lane, Zai, you know, he's got just a tough lane. Who's going to make the recovery?
Puppy's coming in. He slows down super. There is a Yule Scepter complete on Arteezy, but he can't quite get in range. If he gets a range there for the Yules, that's a kill.
Yeah.
And this is an item that can turn the game. As the panel talked about, Vici are very squishy. The main hero who can get tanky here is Black, and he's already starting to get there with the point booster, but any hero caught by the Yules is a free kill with the Requiem, or just with a couple raises and like a Lion Hex or stun. So
yeah. Also,
they still have plenty of kill opportunity to turn this game around.
Before Ice gets his 4 staff, if he blinks in and gets picked up by the Yule Scepter, Ice is dead. So it's a very good defensive item against the Batrider, in conjunction of it being an offensive item for the Shadow Fiend as well. Meanwhile, look at Zai. He's picked up an early medallion. We saw ZSMJ do this on the carry Juggernaut.
Yeah, they bought the medallion, and then that's when they smoked into Roche, hoping to just take the Aegis and snowball the game from there. But Vici were in position to slow it down, and so far the medallion, it's still a nice pickup. They have a very high physical damage item, but it has yet to really show its worth.
Yeah. I mean, again, we cannot forget about the defensive usage of that.
Putting that's
true. Against a sniper, that's pretty good.
Yeah, you've got Stone Gaze plus sniper's auto attacks. It's a lot of physical damage.
Yeah.
Something that
although,
you need to keep in mind.
If you put a medallion on an ally, the Stone Gaze, like, purge it off? Does that have that effect? I'm not sure.
I'm not sure how that particular interaction works.
S4 is going to try to catch up a little bit, like you said, dying a lot of time. But it looks like he's going to finish the mech here, which desperately he needs.
They're going to smoke Zai and Kuroki now making their way bottom. They have an Omni Slash at the ready. Fingers also online.
Ooh.
And they're going to fight super off the bat. This is a big one. Lasso, but Ice blinks into the impale. The Fingers there. Now the Lasso trying to turn this as Kuro gets dragged back. The Healing Ward keeping him healthy for now. They'll purge him. Kill off that Healing Ward. Can they do it? It's still juking around through the tree line. Now Puppy arrives. They blast him down, though, and bring in more reinforcements.
They
have a leap forward. Arrows hunting. And the creep going to tank it.
Yeah, I think it's
now they're TPing in more. Secret want to take this fight. They've got S4 in tow. He still hasn't completed the mech,
but
they're going to chase anyway.
Dusa, how do you run past Dusa? Dusa's going to turn on Stone Gaze, right? Here comes S4 arrow. No, Sarstorm's going to hit on two here. Puppy's immediately dead, and they just have to run Arteezy. Coming on the back line here, if you could get a Yule's initiate, but they see him as well. There's a ward on the ramp.
They actually had the mech recipe on the courier. He did already have it. It just hadn't been delivered yet.
Yeah, if he actually popped the mech there, it would have turned the fight around.
Oh, man. One of those crazy back-and-forth games where both teams, they can feel the intensity, how close the match is, and that graph really tells the story of the game. Just when you think one team gets a bit of an edge with a punch, there's a counter blow that brings it right back to dead even.
Yeah, you know how you said during the mid-game, this Vici Gaming lineup can't really take fight well? Well, the surprising thing is that Black is teleporting into every single fight And just the threat of a Stone Gaze is letting them win these kind of small
scale
engagements.
Honestly, if he was AFK farming, like he kind of was on the Queen of Pain last game, I think Secret would be running them over.
Exactly.
But his presence in the fights is saving teammates and also, in some cases, even netting them kills.
Yeah. I mean, the mid, right? The S4 wouldn't have died there if it wasn't Stone Gaze hitting them. Kuro trying to get this D ward off, but a looming arrow. You gotta be careful of that.
Here's your big item for Arteezy now. He does pick up the Blink Dagger. Oh, they saw him! Walk into the shop. Can they actually go on this? Shrapnel number one coming out. They're canceling the Blink Dagger. He can't retreat out easily. He Yules dodges the Assassinate. More heroes streaming in now. They're bringing in a lot of reinforcements. Requiem comes out. Arteezy gonna go down. Super dropping low to the Death Requiem as an Omni Slash was actually not available yet. Zai on the chase now. S4 getting purged and slowed down. They're gonna kite and control this Bristle. Arrow missing narrowly. Goo coming out. He's a bit of a raid boss with the mech.
The Sniper though on the back line. He's just blinking away, maybe not doing a ton of damage.
They still have Stone Gaze, but they are Mana Draining Black. Now the Imp's doing more and more damage as his Mana Shield gets close to running out. Super, still trying to lay into Secret, has to be careful. The Stone Gaze comes out. That forces the retreat. Now Kuro backing off. Creeps turn to stone. The two hero impale. Nicely done by Kuro. Ice blinking over the top. He gets Omni Slash. Executed almost immediately. They still chase forward. Damn, Secret are tanky. They just can't get any kills yet. Now maybe they do. They bring down one. They blink down a second. At long last, the Sniper works his way through their armor. They'll disrupt. They'll set up for an arrow. That hits Kuro. It's four dead. It could be five. It will be five. Fiji Gaming bringing the entire squad down.
Shadowfiend teleports in, but immediately blinks back out.
Oh, man.
I mean, this Dusa last pick was so perfect. How do you run past the Dusa and get to the Sniper? You can't. Sniper on the back line. He's just hitting away. Sure, he might not be doing that much damage right now, but in 5 minutes, he will be hitting much harder.
And now they purge Arteezy. There's nobody who can come to his aid. There's no buybacks. Arteezy may go down again. Rip. He starts chucking out raises. He can't even get a single kill. Another Death Requiem. Secret are just collapsing under the pressure from Vici Gaming. And the graph reflects it. It plummets downwards. Tier 1 falling top. Oh my, Lumi. They looked invincible before this series. It's not over yet, but it's more just we haven't seen this from them to date.
Yeah, I'm just thinking about how Secret could actually take a fight where it isn't like bull rush head in, because who's gonna be the initiate, right? I guess you have to have Lion to get a blink.
Yeah,
or the Juggernaut to get a blink.
It feels like that, or maybe even the Jug getting a blink or a Shadow Blade. But walking headlong into Vici, you're walking into Shrapnel. The Batrider can counter lasso. They can disrupt
the
anyone that you
purge.
Do manage to jump. They have really good solutions for Bristleback, which. Yeah. I feel like a lot of teams just have not drafted in a way that allows them to deal with that hero, but...
Shadow Demon, like, what a hero. It just makes Bristleback somewhat useless. He can be very tanky, but Soul Catcher changes that. Demonic Purge just basically says, your movement speed is gone, and my sniper can hit you.
That's the thing, is when you see a Shadow Demon Mirana, you're like, they have to get a lot done in this laning stage.
Right.
Or they're just going to fall off, but... The Shadow Demon is so useful this game against what Secret bring to bear.
Oh my god, Black has a Eye of Skadi. Sniper has an SMY. Like, this Bristleback is going to move so slowly.
You start walking backwards into your team when he's trying to run away.
That's the old joke. Like, you know, what is he going to do?
How slow can you go? We're probably going to find out here soon. And to make matters worse... I think even a bigger item is Fenrir almost completing a four staff. The Batrider just grabbed one. Ice. Secret are a team that need to walk into you, as you've been pointing out throughout the cast. And these four staffs just make it easier and easier to kite, and also to just disengage if a hero's ever caught out of position.
Okay, how about this?
How does Secret come back now? What is the game plan here?
Okay, here's a proposition, and I'm not sure whether it will work or not. You're Shadow Fiend, right? You get a BKB. You just blink in the middle and just force in Requiem. Does that work? In theory, Batrider could cancel it.
They
with
can lasso.
But when you're lassoing the Shadow Fiend in the middle, that's where your Bristleback, your Juggernaut just storm in, right? That's the point. Or is that just too YOLO and
I guess
too hard?
With the double force, you can also just double force away. I guess then Secret maybe can chase you down away from the creep wave. He needs that BKB if he wants to go for a play like that.
Yeah.
Which, yeah, he still is a ways off.
Well, looks like we're going to see a play on the tier 2. They might actually find one.
They might find Super. This will be big. Yule's going to find him. I don't even think they try to defend him. He's completely caught up. They will TP in the Batrider, but it's far too late. Nice pick there by Secret. But it doesn't lead to an objective yet, and I guess the question is, do they want to try to force this tower? Or do they maybe swing around towards the big Rockman and go into Roche?
Getting Roche is huge, right? Because
they're against Batrider and Shadow Demon, though. A lot of vision control around the pit.
But Sniper is kind of their damage dealer, especially. Oh, Lasso. Here comes Lasso.
They found one, but the ult from Arteezy was ready. Arrow coming in hot. Will connect on Puppy, but Omni Slash ends Ice off the bat. Fenrir going in one by one. VG Gaming engaged. They need Black to support here. He throws out the Scotty. Oh my goodness, this Dusa is strong right now. Stone gazing and charging forward. Arteezy gets off the Requiem, but he dies and explodes in a cloud of just destruction. Now Black chasing forward, fighting his way past the Shadow Fiend onto the back lines. Mana Drain will make him a whole lot more squishy, though. He's forced back now. Soul Catcher coming out onto S4. They will disrupt it.
Back in 5 seconds. That could be huge. If they actually
stick charges as well on Black. He's not quite as squishy as you think. They'll set up for an arrow now. Zai trying to dodge it with a Blade Fury. He'll be successful. But that Sniper's coming in. They need to retreat now.
Yeah, they know.
Can they get in range for a disruption? It doesn't look like
I think Kuro might get picked off, though. Kuro does have Finger still. He can actually kill FY, I think. Your Finger, drop him, Lopon! The very last tick, any Hadouken from the creep? No.
Oh, man.
It goes the other way.
This game, every kill coming down to just split seconds and tiny fractions of HP. But it seems time and again, VG Gaming just getting the slight upper hand in those trades. And now a lineup that really is not good at taking Roche is just going to have a freebie.
Yeah, also, the surprising thing for me is Black took a point-blank Requiem of Soul, and he lost like 20% health. Mono Shield is just such a powerful ability.
The Medusa has been... It's crazy to think about it, but in these mid-game fights, the Medusa has been their bulwark. Like,
she's the queen of...
The way a lot of teams have been running this hero, like, good example would be Big God. Birdie will come to fights... very occasionally. But
it's like 2010 Medusa, right? You just farm.
Yeah, generally the entire lineup is just built around turtling and getting burning to late game. Like, you saw Xiao 8 was on the Bristleback, he was their frontliner, while Birdie just kept on farming in their first game against Cloud9 yesterday. This game, totally different approach. The Dusa is their team fighter.
Yeah.
Everyone else is just there for pickoffs and, you know, long-range artillery in the case of the Sniper.
Oh, Puppy is going to get caught. Centaur Stomp is actually going to hit. Ice is going to take a ton of damage. Four staff away. Fenrir, though, is going to pop the Purge. And it looks like Puppy, nice Assassinate. Give him that vision. But it looks like they don't even need a...
He's almost got level 3 Assassinate, which is a lot of damage, by the way. 655.
Yep.
Puppy currently sitting on... less than 1,000 HP. Oh, actually, no, he's got Point Booster. He's fairly tanky, but still, they're able to burst him down. Demon Edge up for your Sniper. Oh, man.
So, do you think it's going to be MKB next for him?
They don't really have anyone who's going to be building Evasion. It could just be a straight Daedalus.
I mean, MKB is just a safer choice. Nice damage, right?
It's safer as well, because it really discourages like that Shadow Fiend Butterfly build.
Yeah.
Which we do see quite often.
Also, Secret is working with decent armor heroes, so having some magical damage is... not bad per se.
Secret trying to hang on. Their tower under siege. Super marching in, aggressively posting up. He's confident with the Aegis. He's got Black by his side. And now bottom lane. The lasso on Arteezy coming out. They'll pull him deep back as Fenrir rotates in. Can he four step? In 5 seconds he can. Yules is there. It's going to actually set up for them to jump on top of him. They disrupt him, preventing that Requiem. The Purge already used. Arteezy won't even get it off. Down he goes again. Fenrir, your mega kill support Shadow Demon. 6-1-10. What a performance for the two supports it's been.
Yeah, I know FY gets a lot of hype for his, like, you know, next level plays, but I think Fenrir has played extremely solid this series. That Witch Doctor Maelstrom build, this game, his Shadow Demon play has been absolutely on point. The Demonic Purges, Soul Catchers, everything has been good.
And he's been in position as well. Like, you remember early bottom lane when Secret tried to push the tower, Ice Fireflies almost got caught. The Shadow Demon was there anyway, so even if he does get caught, they just disrupt him and he's absolutely fine.
I think that's the hardest part about playing Shadow Demon, like, being there before the fight even happens.
It's not a mobile hero, right? Like, the Morana can get around pretty quickly, but your Shadow Demon's got to do it the good old-fashioned way with below-average move speed to boot.
Well, Zai is trying to get a T1 top, and looks like they'll take it for free, but...
Yeah, I don't... VG Gaming TPing in here. That would be a way to lose one hero by one and possibly just throw away this lead they've managed to accumulate. Now a 10,000 gold lead, though, Lumi. 12,000 experience. Secret, the way they're itemizing, very mid-game centric. The Shadow Fiend Blink Yules now going into Yasha. The Juggernaut going drums as well as Medallion for Zai. S4, BKB mech. Nobody's gearing up for a beefy late game, and it makes you worry if Secret can't find that game-changing fight sometime in the next 5-10 minutes.
Yeah. It's about finding the fight and then having the hero to initiate, right? Vichy has the Batrider, so they could... whenever they spot somebody out in the jungle, in the river, they could get a free pick. Secret doesn't have the option. I mean, Lion, in theory, could do it.
He still doesn't have Blink. When is the last time that you've seen Kuroki with no Blink on a Lion, a Rubick, like an Initian here along those lines at 27 minutes? I don't know if I can remember having seen it at all this tournament.
I mean, when have you seen Secret lose all three lanes?
That's not very often. Lasso coming in bottom lane on S4. We drag back into an arrow, but he BKBs just in the nick of time. They can kill him through this, though, I think. Chasing him on with the sniper, hitting fairly hard. Even if they don't kill him, they're in trouble regardless. Now Medusa lane in S4. They're diving him to the base.
He's
so they really
not moving. He's just so slow.
That's a very slow Armadillo.
Yeah, and his team is not supporting him.
They're in position to break the base. They're trying to split push, but they don't have that tiny win.
They trying to base?
They can't base race, Vici. They're just too far in. Maybe they try to trade, but it looks like it won't be a favorable trade at this rate.
Super is super out of position, though. He's like up the ramp in front of his team, but
he's got Aegis, though.
Fair enough.
You go on him, then Black is there to kind of initiate. They also have the double force staff disruption if the Batrider's in the area, which so far he is. So
I guess they're playing the game of chicken. Who's going to back off first? Oh. It's Poppy trying to defend on the front line.
Assassinate might even kill him.
Oh, Kuroki got immediately disrupted. Kuroki's going to be dead. Just two hits. The arrow's going to finish him off. Assassinate coming from afar. Is Poppy going to die? Yes. Kabow.
They can't even walk into the Rex. They walk into the Rex and these supports, they just die. S4, he dies slowly rather than quickly. They force out that Enchantress buyback. S4 surging in, but they can just start kiting him and go back on him. His BKB still cooling down because it was the 10-second charge. S4 going to die again. 2-8 his score as Vici. They sense blood in the water.
Oh,
they sense weakness.
It.
This could be the end. It's a dieback for Puppy. It's a lane of Rex, and they're going even deeper now for a lasso at the top lane. Ice.
Oh, what
slowing
about
down Arteezy, who's still been split pushing this whole time. But now Black's here to greet him. He can't TP out as quickly as he grabs the gem. It goes back the other way. He's yet to crack the base, and they may go back in bottom. Fenrir looking in for this initiation with the disruption. They'll start it off. Arrow. Not going to go for it. They'll instead go for Kuro. Leap forward. FY ready to body block. Whatever he can, and it's not even needed.
Juggernaut
gets the kill.
He's
dies third spin. It's a wipe.
He's stuck between the two Elysian and that 3-2-2 Ziggurat or whatever it's called, the building. What a disruption by Fenrir. He just got right clicked.
Secret down. Getting run over. 31-10. They're down by 20k gold. You look at the gold graph, and it's not even the numbers. It's just peppered with red dots from all the kills VG Gaming have been racking up.
I mean,
This is a stomp.
I guess if you're going up against Secret, you look at what Vici's doing. Because four games in a row, Vici has beat Secret in the laning stage. But none as hard as this game.
Well, the hometown favorites here for Vici Gaming. They're so far looking strong, and they're on the verge of taking the Series 2-1 winner. Guaranteed top three at the Dota 2 Asia Championships. They lay in now to the melee Rex. Man, they've already taken one lane of Rex Secret on their last legs. They gotta find a way to engage, but how do you go onto the Dusa? They disrupt her as soon as the Hex comes out. The Rays won't even hit. Now they leap in with the lasso, pulling Arteezy in deep. He dies in a matter of seconds. No buyback, no way out for Secret. They're getting slaughtered in their own base. S4 likely to be next. He'll go down. Three more dead at GG. Vici Gaming guaranteed top three at DAC. Secret no longer undefeated.
You know, this game, I am extremely impressed with the way that Black played the Dusa. You talked about it. If Dusa did not join those early game fight, they could have got overrun. But Stone Gaze is a strong, strong fighting tool early on, mid game.
The crazy part is how bad the laning stage looked like it was going to start. They smoke. It doesn't work. They drop two wards, both spotted by Secret.
Didn't get dewarded, though. One of them.
One of them didn't get dewarded. But man, just from top to bottom, Secret, just a rough game for them.
Yeah.
Everybody struggled here.
I mean, I think they're still the favorite team to come out of the loser bracket. But you got some feisty team down there, and you don't want to take anything for granted.
Well, the scary thing as well, though, is, I mean, maybe teams look at these Vici Gaming matches as well and feel more confident.
It's like, this is how you beat Secret.
Nobody's going to say Secret is easy, but at least they're not immortal, right? They have lost. They can lose if you play right. And
lose in very spectacular fashion, I might have.
I don't know if I would say this is a recipe for beating Secret, because I